I'm at Manassas Presbyterian Church, where we just finished a mini weekend retreat called Jumpstart. As you can imagine from the name, it's an opportunity to get things moving for a future direction for the church, to get some clarity about their priorities for mission and ministry ahead. This church is in the middle of a pastoral transition. So out of this mini retreat, they got two things. They got to say, we did a mission study. We got clarity on who we are and where we're headed. And they will also have a completed myth out of this process that they can vote on as a session and begin to send out to the world. A myth is a ministry information form to collect information from future candidates who might be excited about what this church is up to and how a new pastor might partner with them to continue moving forward. Your committee on ministry knows that there are a lot of transitions ahead of us. So if your church or you as a pastor are about to face these transitions, your first step is to call me. Let our office know and we can start connecting you to doing a process much like this that takes a weekend, that does very good, thoughtful work in the congregation around clarity on where they're headed next. There's a whole lot more to come, so stay tuned.
Good morning. We're here today, in case you read Mary Beth's little email this morning, to let you know we older adults do not just sit around in our rocking chairs. So we're here to prove it. So welcome to the third annual Older Adult Sunday here at GPC. It's a pleasure to have you all here, and we come together to rejoice in the Lord.
Thank you. Will you please join with me in the call to worship? I was glad when they said to me, let us go to the house of the Lord. We come running and on walkers, with hurried steps and halting, to join together in response to your call. This is the day you have made for us, our Creator, a day for us to join in praise and worship of you. We give thanks for this day, for this world, and for this whole creation which you have called good. You gather us together as our Good Shepherd. For your care of us our whole lives long, we praise your name. Let us worship God. Would you join me in prayer, please? Dear God, grant us the patience to work together with understanding and with compassion in our hearts. Lead us to take what you have given us, love, mercy, grace, and forgiveness, as we strive to light the way to your heavenly kingdom. In Jesus' name, amen.
Call to confession. O Lord, we know how easy it is to go astray, to depart from your word and your way. Hear our confession and restore us to your family. Dear Lord, you have created all of us, but sometimes we want to look only to youth and ignore our elders. Sometimes we act as though only the oldest, the longest standing members have anything to offer. Remind us, O God, we are all your called out people. Forgive us when we forget one group by age or race or gender or ethnic origin. Help us to see you in each person. Restore us all by your grace into one family. Amen. Time for silent prayer. Assurance of prayer. This is the good news we have received, that anyone, no matter what age or origin, is forgiven, for they are now welcomed by God if they put their trust in Jesus as Lord. Thanks be to God for this good news.
Could all the children come forward, please? You can move over here, is that okay? Oopsie, I'll let you pass it to your sister. Oopsie. One for you. I may have to let the two of you share, is that okay? There's so many more people than I expected. But if, oops, let me give it to these little ones. No secrets, no secrets. Del, you didn't get one? All right, I have two left. Does everybody have one? All right, so now I'm going to give you just a second. And I want you to take a close look at what's in your bag. Don't say anything, just use your eyes. Okay, now wiggle your little finger if you'd like to tell me what you think is in this bag. Yes. Money? Good thinking. Yes. Pennies. Yes. 5 pennies. Oh, we're getting more and more details. All right. What made you decide that you thought that was pennies? This time let's wiggle your pointer finger. What made you think it was coins, money, 5 pennies? Point your finger. Yes. They're brown. Yes. They're made out of copper. We're getting very sophisticated. Good answer. Any other ideas? All right. What can you tell me about pennies? Anything? Say what?
Miss what?
Oh, they have words. Okay. Okay. I'm going to call on someone else since we had some good answers from you. Is that okay? Yes.
It has Abraham Lincoln on it.
Okay. Any other things you know about pennies?
Can buy stuff with them.
Okay. How much are pennies worth? Everybody, let me hear.
1 cent.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Take a good look at those coins. Some of those coins are really old. And some of them are bright and shiny. Are you trying to tell me that those old coins are worth 1 cent, just like the bright and shiny ones? What do you think, Telly?
If they were shiny, probably not. Or maybe.
Anybody else have an idea? he said maybe when they were older, younger, they would have been. Anybody else have an idea? Well, you are right. They're all pennies. No matter how old they are, oh, that sort of makes me think about people, right? And how bright and shiny they are, they're still worth the same. Could you see if that will fit in your hand? So I don't want them to, you to lose any of them. Thank you very much. So it's just like I remind, make when I think about people. God loves each one of us, whether they're old or young. So if God loves each of us just the same, no matter if we're old or young, if we like to ride bikes or read books, does he love each of us the same? Yes. So what do you think God wants us to do if he loves all of us? Yes.
Love him.
Love him. Okay, I'll let you say it.
Respect him.
Okay. Respect him, she said. Do you think God might want us to love other people all the same? No matter if they're old or young, shiny, whether they like to ride bikes or go to read books. So there's a verse in the Bible from Romans that says, God shows no partiality. That's a really kind of weird word, long. Does anybody have any ideas about what partiality might mean? Yes.
Is this book?
Okay. From a book? Yes.
Learn from books?
Okay. Partiality means no favorites. God has no favorites, and he hopes we will have no favorites. Let us pray. We know that God loves us, and let us remember that just like the pennies, whether they're old or they're new, he values each one of them the same, just like he values us, and he wants us to share that love with other people, whether they are the same or different from us as well. Amen. Now, before you leave, I have another little thing for you. This is a hand lens, and when you get home, you can put this in your bag for now, and then later you can use this hand lens and explore those pennies, those old ones and those new ones, and you can verify whether they all have the same letters on, the same pictures, those kinds of things, okay? So I'll give this to you, and then Miss Carolyn is going to be ready to take you. Thank you all very much. You for waiting. You were very patient. Well, it was. Sleep.
Good morning. As we prepare our hearts for the word of God today, let's join in the prayer of illumination. Your word is a table set before us that sustains us all of our lives. May our hearts and minds be open, so we will be nourished by these scriptures and this worship, and then be ready to be Christ's disciples, going where you send us. Amen. Our first scripture reading comes from Philippians chapter 4, from verse 4 to 7. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus.
Please join me as we read responsively from the 13th chapter of 1 Corinthians, commonly known as the chapter of love. If I speak in the tongues of mortals and of angels, but do not have love, I am a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And if I have prophetic powers and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and I have faith so as to remove mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give away all my possessions, and if I hand over my body so that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice in wrongdoing, but rejoices in the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. But as for prophecies, they will come to an end. As for tongues, they will cease. As for knowledge, it will come to an end. For we know only in part, and we prophesy only in part. But when the complete comes, the partial will come to an end. When I was a child, I spoke like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became an adult, I put an end to childish ways. For now we see in a mirror dimly, but then we will see face to face. Now I know only in part, then I will know fully, even as I have been fully known. And now faith, hope, and love abide. These three, and the greatest of these is love. The word of God for the people of God.
Good morning. Thanks to Asenath for reading Philippians 4:4 through 7. That will be the major focus of my little talk this morning. Rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. Let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. Joy is a major theme in Paul's letter to the church in Philippi. And I think an important reason for that is that in chapter 1, verse 4, it says, this is Paul writing to the Philippians, "In all my prayers for all of you, I always pray with joy because of your partnership in the gospel." Your partnership in the gospel from the first day until now. And how was the Philippian church partners with Paul in the gospel? Well, they were a pretty strong church, I believe, founded by Paul and Silas and Timothy. You remember how Paul had a vision one night of a man begging him to come to Macedonia and help us. Philippi was the prosperous Roman colony in Macedonia near the coast, and it was a place where Paul found a truly positive response. Their partnership included preaching the gospel in and around Philippi in Paul's absence, helping Paul financially and with co-workers, both in the continuing missionary journeys and later when they learned that he was under house arrest in Rome. I imagine they also were a significant contributor to Paul's collection for the gift to the poor believers in Jerusalem. As a side note, Paul ended up in Rome as a result of that trip to Jerusalem. Riots were started in Jerusalem by groups that opposed Paul's outreach to the Gentiles, and Paul was imprisoned. However, when the commander of the Roman military there learned that Paul was a Roman citizen, the commander had to treat him with some respect. But after Paul had been subjected to several pseudo trials and was still in prison, Paul declared, "I appeal to Caesar." And under Roman law, the authorities had to arrange for Paul to be taken to Rome. When Paul arrived in Rome, he was allowed to rent a place to live with a soldier to guard him. Now, the story from Paul's arrest in Jerusalem through to his arrival in Rome fills the last eight chapters of Acts and required several long years for Paul to make that transition. The last two verses in the book of Acts say, "For 2 whole years, Paul stayed there in his rented house in Rome and welcomed all who came to see him. He proclaimed the kingdom of God and taught about Lord Jesus Christ with all boldness and without hindrance." Here is Paul, a prisoner in Rome, speaking the word of God to all who would come to him. Amazing. Paul's letter to the Philippians was likely written near the end of his 2 years under the house arrest in Rome. Now, let's come back to the scriptures that Asenath read. Thank you very much for the reading. And Philippians 4:4, rejoice in the Lord always. I will say it again, rejoice. But what does it mean to rejoice in the Lord? Well, as we grow deeper in our faith and in our relationship with the Lord, we may begin to see him more and more clearly at work in our lives and in our families and in our church. We begin to recognize more frequently the effects of God's steadfast love and grace in us and around us, and we feel ourselves being drawn more deeply and confidently into the work that he is calling us to. Therefore, we rejoice in the Lord. In verse 5, let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near. I think Paul is saying here that people should notice that we are gentle in our relationships with others, in this underlying joy that comes from our relationship with God. And the Lord is near. Do you remember when Jesus came, when Jesus said, come to me, all you who are weary and carrying heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am gentle and humble in heart, and you will find rest for your souls, for my yoke is easy and my burden is light. So Jesus says that he is gentle and humble in heart, and he is our Lord and Savior. In Philippians 6 and 7, we read, do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition with thanksgiving, present your requests to God, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. So, anxiety seems to be approaching pandemic level in our society. Paul recognized it as potentially disabling even among Christians in his time. But thanks be to God, Paul offers us an answer. If you find yourself beginning to worry about some situation or already deep in anxiety over some problem that you're having a hard time figuring out, or maybe it's already getting worse, Paul says that the most important thing we can do is to bring it to God in prayer. In fact, it has been suggested that Paul is encouraging us, when we're beginning to become anxious, to accept that as a gift of the Spirit calling us to prayer. To accept that anxiousness, that as a gift of the Spirit calling us to prayer. The reference to that citation is GPC News, April 4, with the initials MBL. More specifically, we're called to present our requests or petitions with thanksgiving, rejoicing in the Lord. That's not to say that our prayer regarding anxiety needs to be limited to petition with thanksgiving, although that's important. But praise, worship, confession, intercession for others, all aspects of prayer may be appropriate depending on the situation. Finally, the hoped-for, anticipated, promised blessing from this prayer that Paul describes will be relief from the anxiety and receiving the peace of God, which transcends all understanding. Going forward, Paul goes on to say that this peace will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. This peace will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus. Thanks be to God. Amen.
In 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 7, we read, "Each of you must give as you have made up your mind, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. Your gift is a seed that will reap a harvest of blessings for you and for others."
Thank you.
Please join me in the prayer of thanksgiving for all the gifts you give us, O God, gifts that come with age as well as those that are part of youth. We give you thanks. In response to your greatest gift, Jesus Christ, we respond with these gifts we offer. May the gifts and the giver be blessed, and may the gifts be used to bring good news to your world. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Prayers of the People. Dear Lord, may your love continue to thrive. May your loving spirit continue to breathe new life into a broken place of our world and into our own hearts. May we be agents of your resurrecting power, bringing hope and healing and reconciliation wherever we go. Wherever your love is, we will try to follow. Please join me in the Lord's Prayer. We will pray this in Jesus' name, who taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
We've heard a lot of messages, both by video in terms of the importance of our Jumpstart meeting coming on Saturday, as well as some rather strong messages from our pastors of how important our voices are to be heard. So just a reminder that this coming Saturday is our Jumpstart, and we look forward to having as many people possible come so we can share our ideas. Reservations have been taken simply because we want to make sure we have enough food. So you're welcome to bring your own lunch, but we will be serving four different varieties of subs, soup, salad, chips, and fruit. So look forward to seeing you. If you haven't yet given us your name in terms of your intentions to come, it would be helpful just to make sure we have enough food for everybody. And then moving on to announcements. I've been asked to announce that tonight at 6:30, the orchestra will be having a concert here at GPC. We've also been hearing the word about the rebuilding day, Rebuilding Montgomery, which is going to be taking place on April the 27th, where our congregation goes and to a local home to do some home improvements that are important and well needed. It's been a very productive project for years, and I don't know if Yao is here or not, but Yao's the man to see in terms of your ability and interest in participating in that to get more information. So thank you.
Thank you.
You may be seated. Now, your visit at church today will not be complete until you swing by Lindsay Hall and experience all the wonderful muffins that are there, baked by the seniors of our church as well as by the youth. So they're there for you to enjoy, take home. We would just ask that you give a donation, which will go to the Youth's Summer Camp Scholarship Fund. Loving God, we are thankful for the seasons of life. May we leave today with grateful hearts to go out into the world to show others God's love. The peace of Christ be with you.
And also with you.
Thank you for joining us.